What do spiderwebs, diamonds, and one-of-a-kind materials have in common? They've all been used in the world's most energetic laser to get us a little bit closer to achieving nuclear fusion ignition, and to give us even more answers about some of the most extreme interactions in the universe. Hold up, we need some more background info. The world's most energetic laser is called the National Ignition Facility, or NIF. NIF lives at Lawrence Livermore National Lab in a building big enough to fit 3 football fields inside it.
What we are trying to do at the National Ignition Facility is to create self-sustaining fusion. We want to fuse hydrogen atoms together, and in order for us to do that, we need to hold those hydrogen atoms in place.
To put it really simply, inside this huge chamber is the target. It's about the size of an eraser head, and inside of that is an even smaller container called a capsule, about the size of a peppercorn. The capsule is what contains fuel, often a certain kind of hydrogen. When a shot goes off at NIF, all the energy from those laser beams hits the target, and everything inside the capsule, the fuel, is all being squashed down to try and fuse those atoms together.
There are several things that are hard about targets. The first one is that many times the targets require fairly perfect materials. So when we look at capsules, for example, they can't have pits on the surface, they can't have voids in the material, they have to be perfectly round, they have to have uniform wall thicknesses. So making a perfect capsule is a very hard thing in and of its own.
Basically, any imperfection in these tiny target components can have huge effects on the outcome of the shot. Now, NIF and other facilities around the world aren't just interested in fusing hydrogen atoms together, creating fusion. We actually do that fairly often at NIF, but they're working towards what's called fusion ignition, which would be when we get more energy out of this fusion interaction than we put into creating it. And this would be pretty much world-changing. In August of 2021, NIF got closer than ever to achieving fusion ignition by producing 1.3 megajoules of energy. And that was thanks, in part, to diamonds, laser's best friend.
What we're looking for in a capsule is a high density, as high as we can get it, but at the same time, a low atomic number. So we can only use light elements like carbon or hydrogen. And so among those light elements, actually, diamond has one of the highest densities that you can get.
And the crazy thing is, these diamond capsules are actually grown. A company called Diamond Materials is a German LLNL collaborator that creates the diamond capsules from gas. This superheated gas creates a plasma, which results in carbon atoms being deposited onto a mold in the shape of the capsule, layer by molecular layer.
However, it is a little bit different than the diamond that you would use for your ring, for example. It is not as shiny, and the diamond that is your best friend can be a single crystal and is very transparent. The diamond that we grow comes in 2 different flavors.
We have what we call microcrystalline diamond, which has crystal size of around 3 microns. And then we have nanocrystalline diamond, which is even smaller. And so because you have all these little crystallites in your diamond shell, it doesn't look translucent and beautiful, it looks gray. And is actually fairly opaque.
So after the capsules are created, essentially out of thin air, we got to get rid of all those imperfections, right?
So if you imagine squashing the capsule, like take a helium-filled party balloon and try and squish it with your fingers. And imagine how difficult that would be to squash this balloon perfectly and smoothly all the way down until it was the size of something like a pea.
This is Paul Fitzsimmons. He works at General Atomics down in San Diego, which is another collaborator that works closely with the national labs and other scientific institutions.
The types of things that we're making are millimeter size little capsules, and we're really worried about features that are teeny tiny, something the size of like a Hollywood sign on the surface of the Earth. So imagine something that small on something that big, and they're the types of things that we're really interested in.
That is really the major improvement that was done between the early shots in this campaign and the record shot is that we were able to find and see those voids and then start changing the production process so that those voids and the pits on the surface would be removed. overall, the capsules that we shot on the record shot are 100 times better in both voids and pits than the stuff that we did early on.
In the diamond capsules, we smooth the surface, we measure the entire capsule. So we're looking at the surface of the capsule, the wall thickness, and what's inside of the wall itself. And then we assemble some of the sub-assemblies here and ship them to Lawrence Livermore, where the General Atomics team on site at the NIF assemble the targets into their final package. We're also developing measurement techniques so we can measure things on and inside of the capsules that we've never been able to achieve before. So of course, as we make something better, that we have to make a device to measure it even better, so we can see more and more and more detail.
So one of the improvements that we're working on right now is the next generation of capsule material. It is not thought right now that diamond is the end all of it. The major problem that people who are thinking about the experiments are seeing is that there is a crystalline to the diamond. They're not like a glass, which has no crystals at all. So what we're looking into right now is a set of materials that are glassy, that don't have any kind of crystals left. And we anticipate that those will work better than a crystalline material for the implosions on NIF.
Now, when it comes to optimizing the targets and capsules to improve energy yields on NIF, improving target and capsule design and materials is really just the beginning. And in fact, the innovation we want to share with you next is so cool, it deserves its own video. So make sure you subscribe to this channel to catch it when it comes out soon. And fair warning, it involves spiders. If you have questions about this work or other stuff going on at the lab, leave them for us in the comments below. And thanks so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one.